Hello friends, this is Dalpa Sonagra, Assistant Professor in Computer Science Engineering Department, Government Women Engineering College. This lecture is in continuation of my previous lecture, Simplification of Context-Free Grammar Part 2. And in this lecture, Part 3, we discuss the construction of reduced grammar G1 corresponding to a given context-free grammar G. Before starting this, we just understand what actually meaning of reduced grammar. So consider we have a given grammar G that is context free grammar. Okay, so this G is said to be a reduced or non-redundant if every symbol from the set V union sigma appears in the course of derivation for some terminal string. Means the every symbol, a symbol may be either variable or a terminals, R appears in the course of derivation for some terminal string at the end. Means our last sentential form is in the terminals only. So we can understand this by some notation, formal language like this. If X is a symbol belongs to the V union sigma, then there exists a derivation which starts from the starting variable. Okay, and after multiple transaction, if we reach to a situation where we found X in between the alpha and beta. Of course, this alpha and beta also belongs to V union sigma, and X is also belongs to V union sigma. So here the point is the X which is belongs to V union sigma, and the left context is the alpha string and right context is beta string. Okay, then this total representation converted purely into the terminal string, that is what W, and that terminal strings, or we can say the sentential form in which the total string is in terminal, represented in terminal, then that is actually derived, the one of the string belongs to the language of that grammar G. So the simple words, if we start with the starting variable and we reach to the purely terminal string, and in between all the variables and terminals present at least once in the course of derivation, then that grammar is known as the simplified grammar or a simplified language. And the variable and the production and the terminals used to derive that simplified grammar is known as reduced grammar. Other than other all the variables and terminals and production which are not in use or not appears at least once in a presentation, that need to be eliminated from that grammar. So we discuss this by a theorem 3, which is used to construct a reduced grammar G1 by the grammar G. And after the conversation, the language which is described by G1 should be equivalent to language which is described by grammar G. This is very simple procedure, and for this we first apply theorem 1, which is we discussed in our earlier lectures in simplification of context-free grammar part 1, and theorem 2 we discussed simplification of context-free grammar in part 2. Both these lectures already available in the playlist. You can go there and see. Okay, so the theorem 1 is used to eliminate all those variables which are not deriving any terminal string. Okay, and after that we use theorem 2, which eliminate all those symbols from the set of variables and the terminals which are not useful for deriving a sentential form. So step one, we apply theorem one, and over the resultant grammar, again we apply theorem two in step second. Let us discuss all this with one example in our next slide. Okay, consider the grammar G having these production. Okay, and accordingly other three tuples you can also describe, means a sigma, a set of terminals having small a and small b, and the set of variable having capital A, capital B, capital C and capital S, and starting variable is of course S. So actually this is a grammar G, and we have to construct a corresponding grammar G1, reduced grammar G2. First we construct a grammar G1, that is by theorem 1 in step 1. After that we go for a grammar G2, that is purely a reduced grammar. So let us see first step. Okay, in first step we apply theorem 1, which eliminate all those variables which not deriving terminal string. Let us discuss how it can be done. Okay, so we have a grammar G and we have to construct grammar G1. Okay, in this case there are simplified set of vertices V1 and corresponding simplified set of production. So how we construct this simplified set of variables? Look, construction of V1, this is we construct by using WI, and this WI is actually a subset of V belongs to grammar G, and this WI is constructed recursively. So first W1 is the set of all those variables which directly derives terminals, and this you can found into the set of production. So if we look at this production, this variable A directly derive a terminal string, so we include this capital A into our W1 set. Again this capital C derived directly the terminal string B, therefore we include this C into our set W1. So W1 is the set of variables A and C. Next we construct W2, that is also we construct recursively. For this we use W1. Okay, so W2 is a set of union of W1 and all those variables which belongs to the production in the form where A1 tends to alpha, where of course A1 belongs to W1 and alpha belongs to sigma union AC. Okay, so please note, this is set of all those variables corresponding to this production where A1 belongs to actually set V. Okay, where the A1 belongs to actually set V of the grammar G, and alpha is any string belongs to sigma union W1. Okay, so if we look at the production this then this This S is belongs to V of a given grammar G. Okay, so we include this production, but there are two type of production. S tends to AB like this, AB and S tends to is CA. Okay, so this S is okay, but in right hand side this is not alpha, because alpha is belongs to sigma union W1. Okay, so A is of course belongs to W1, but this B is not belongs to W1, therefore this S is not included into this set. Okay, next, look at this production in which this S belongs to what? Of course, V, and this alpha belongs to the sigma union W1 set. Therefore, we can choose this variable S into our set. So, we include this S here. In this case, for this production, this B is not belongs to, this B is not. Of course, this B belongs to set V, but this B does not belong to W1 because alpha is not belongs to sigma union AC. Therefore, we not include this, and therefore we in this case this is also false. So therefore, we not include capital B. A is already there, and C is already there. Okay, so. So the new symbol is what? S only, which we include in this. Okay. If you, this thing is clear, then we take the union of W1 and S. Okay. So which is A, C, and S. So this is our W2. Next, again recursively we try to find out the set W3. This is the union of W2 and the set of all those variables which derive the string alpha, which is belongs to the union of sigma and previously calculated W2. Okay, this, but in this case we don't found any such variable, so this is what? Null set. So the union of W2 and null set is also W2. So in this case, we note that W2 equals to W3. Okay. So according to the theorem 1, our W3 is our required set of vertices, simplified vertices, which is deriving the sentential form, or you can say a terminals only. Therefore, the V1 is our set of variables that deriving the terminals. Now, according to this simplified set of vertices, we construct the set of productions. We include all those variables which is in form A tends to alpha, where A belongs to simplified set V1 and alpha belongs to V1 union sigma asterisk. So if we note that this production S tends to CA, then this is we will include this S tends to CA because S is belongs to V1 and CA belongs to V1 union sigma. So we include this. Why we not include S tends to AB? Because B does not belongs to V1 union sigma asterisk. Therefore, we not include S tends to AB. Again, B does not belongs to V1. Therefore, we don't use neither B tends to BC or B tends to AB. So, this is not the required production in a grammar G1. Okay. And of course, this A tends to small a is also included because capital A belongs to V1. Small a belongs to V1 union sigma. Therefore, we include this. Now, C tends to small a and capital B is not included. Why it is? Because because capital B does not belongs to the B1 union sigma asterisk. Sorry, there was interrupt of music. So again, we don't include C tends to small a capital B, but C tends to small b is included because this B belongs to B1 union sigma and this C belongs to V1. So required production are this. So the simplified grammar in step 1 by theorem 1 is this, and corresponding production P1 is this. Now we go for step 2, where we applied theorem 2 over this grammar G1. So let's look. Look that, yes, this is step 2 in which we apply theorem 2 over a simplified grammar G1 produced in step 1. In this we construct G2, which is our required reduced grammar. Okay, so before we constructing a G2, we go for the construction of WI. This WI is a subset of V1. V1. Okay, means a WI is a set of variables. Those are belongs to the set of variables V1, which is constructed in our step 1. And of course, the construction of this WI is recursively for the value of I which is greater than equals to 1. So at first we declare W1 equals to S, the set of starting variable only. If you want to know about more regarding theorem 2, then you should go for our previous lecture, simplification of context-free grammar part 2. Okay, so we construct W1 here like this, okay, which is the set of starting variable only. Now we construct W2 recursively, which is the union of W1 and the set of those symbols which is belongs to V1 union sigma, just like or according to the production A tends to alpha, where this A belongs to WI. Okay, means in first case W1, and alpha is a symbol containing from V1 union sigma. Okay, so in this case the set of those symbols are what? A and capital C. How it is? Because we know that A tends to alpha and A belongs to WI. In this case, WI is what? Of course, the previous one, W1. So in a W1, there is only S. So S derived what? S derived what in the set of production P2? In the set of production P1. In a grammar G1, there are only production S tends to AC and A tends to small a and capital C tends to small b. Therefore, we use only S tends to AC. Okay, A and C. So according to this, because this is in W1, so we include capital A and capital C into this set. Okay, when we taking the union of both, then this is become S capital A and capital C. This is our W2. I hope you understand this. Otherwise, go for the lecture context, the simplification of context-free grammar part 2. Now we construct W3, which is also constructed like the previous step, which is the union of W2. This is W2 and those symbols which derive the production A tends to alpha in the set of production P1 from the grammar G1. Okay, where this A belongs to W2 and alpha belongs to the union of V1 and sigma 1. Okay, So in this case, the production capital, according to the production, capital A tends to small a, because of this A is already present in W2. Okay, so we include what? Sorry, we include small a and capital A both, and capital S and capital A and capital C all, and by the C tends to small c, we include this is this also small c and capital C. So the set, this becomes, there is a printing mistake, you consider here as capital A and capital C also. Okay, when we taking the union of these two sets, then this is of course this one. Hope you understand this. Okay, so when again we recursively construct W4, which is equal to W3, so this is actually our WI, or you can say WK, which is reconstructed over the grammar G1, and which is the subset of V1 and sigma 1 also. Okay, so here this W1 is the union of V1 and sometime a sigma, always this WI is the subset of V1 union sigma 1. Okay, this should also note. Okay, please note this. Now after the construction of this WK, we go for construction of V2, which is the intersection of the V1, which is constructed in previous step 1, and this is WK. So we take the intersection, then we get this. This is our simplified or reduced set of variables. Okay, now we construct the production, where we include the production in the form A tends to alpha, where A belongs to V2 and alpha belongs to WK. So if you think over the all production in set P1, then we include the production like this. In this example, all the production of P1 is included in P2 because all follow these rules and satisfy the properties like this and this. Okay, now again we construct a sigma 2, which is the intersection of sigma 1 and WK. So this is WK and this is our sigma. So required simplified set of terminals is sigma 2, that is A comma B. So now this is a reduced grammar G2, you know, from the corresponding grammar G. This is purely reduced grammar, and the language of G2 and the language of G both are equivalent, means both describe the same set of strings. Hope you understand. Okay, if you have any query, then you can refer the KLP Mishra, and because all the slide and this lecture is the reference from that book of PHI publication I mentioned here. Okay, and otherwise you can mail me at dalpat@gwac.ac.in. Thank you very much.